person and those who are live streaming in from around the country. My name is James Brinkmann. Welcome to the premiere recital for the first annual What If Call for Scores. This is a really exciting project I've been doing for about a year. I started it at the end of my doctorate last year while I was doing research on how we listen to music and how we interpret the meaning of it for ourselves. And during my interviews with many participants, about 48, many of them said, the flute always reminds me of a bird. And I thought, well, of course. We had Prokofiev's Peter and the Wolf, Massenet's Le Merle Noir. We've had so many flute pieces throughout the centuries that have been very bird-like or specifically referencing birds or nature. And so I thought, how can I put my research to practical use as a flute player? I'm gonna invite composers to write new music that is not about making the flute sound like a bird. So I put out a prompt to the world that said, what if the flute represented a character other than a bird? And then I let it be open to any composer of any expertise, any level. They could write of any level of flute repertoire. They could be anywhere from around the world. And I received 128 submissions from 30 countries and people of 26 nationalities. And which really blew me away, actually. And what was fun is there's also been a shortage of beginner and intermediate flute repertoire, especially by new living composers. So I had three categories, beginner, flute repertoire category, an intermediate, and then an advanced professional. And people could submit to any or all of those categories. Then I put together a selection committee of four people. Myself, another professional flutist, Elise Blatchford, and then an adult flute player who's an amateur or an enthusiast, Jerry Lopez, and a non-performing music listener, Ramona Fantini. She's a business owner in South Carolina. And the concert setting is really about the relationship between a performer, the composer, and the listener, and the music is what's tying us all together. And we're all experiencing it in our own ways. So I wanted this selection committee to help us find what flute repertoire is likely going to be interesting to as many demographics as possible who are experiencing this music. And so we each blindly listened to all of these pieces by ourselves, all 128, and then we picked our tops, we ranked them, and then we came together and discussed the finalists and which repertoire we wanted to premiere. And so today, I'll be playing 16 new works in beginner, intermediate, and advanced categories, and that's how they're laid out in today's program. So I'm gonna at the beginning of each category, I'll talk a little bit about what was required for that category and what did I ask composers to think about in terms of skill level, and then I'll play the entire category. If you're interested in learning about the music, you can go to the program, which is on my website, innovativeflutist.com, and under interactive programs, you scroll under and it says call for scores. And if you click on that, you can find a link to, it'll say click for recital program. And on there, it's about 20 pages, it's like a whole program booklet. So for the people who are here live, we're saving paper, so if you want to, you can go scan for the program booklet outside. I'd encourage you to do that before we start. In it, you're gonna find more information about the call. You're gonna find bios of the performers, bios of the selection committee. You'll also find lots of information about the 16 composers tonight, including their bios, their program notes, and how to purchase their music if you are interested. My hope is that this recital is going to promote this new flute repertoire for students and teachers. So without further ado, let's get started with the beginner flute repertoire. There are seven pieces in this category, and the final piece, Prehistoric, that was the grand winner of the beginner category. When thinking about beginner flutists, their stamina is still developing. So each of these pieces is gonna be between 1 and 2 minutes long. They're cute little short pieces. They also work for local solo and ensemble commissions for each state's music education association. So it's something they can use. In addition, the time signatures and the key signatures or the notes that they have to play are within a pretty doable range for being 1 or 2 years of playing, and fairly easy to count. I did want to allow composers to incorporate some extended techniques or new sounds, non-traditional sounds on the flute. So you might hear some little tonguing sounds, like tongue pizzicatos, or key clicks, just little things that could sound fun and not quite like your traditional flute, but it's doable for that level. So with that, let's begin with Valse de Grenouilles, which is Waltz of the Frogs. So the next three pieces are going to be for solo flute. Composers were allowed to write things for flute and piano, or unaccompanied flute, and so I hope you enjoy the Sand Bubbler Crab, the next one. Thank you. beginner category winner, Prehistoric, What If the Flute Represented a Land Dinosaur? By Tyler Zwink. The intermediate flute category, we're looking at a little bit wider demographic of flute student. These are often middle schoolers, maybe high schoolers, and now you're looking a lot at adult flute players who might be playing for fun, returning to the flute after many years, starting it up later in life. So the concepts for the next four pieces, some of them might seem very appropriate for a middle school or high school student, and some of them are a little bit more complex, philosophical, and might be more interesting for an adult flute player. Each of these pieces is between 3 and 4 minutes long. The range of the flute that they could use is a bit wider, so you're getting much more into the high register and almost all the way to the lowest notes of the flute. There is a little bit more room for interesting time signatures, articulations, and extended techniques. So you're going to see a lot more of those throughout, and I hope you enjoy the next four. Thank you. piece, the Galumphing Tortoise, is the only flute and piano piece that was selected to be premiere for the call for scores.
Thank you.
It says, Ksana, droplet lives in a blink, but stalactites are timeless.
Thank you.
flute repertoire category, A Beetle's Journey by Denise Ondishko. She goes by Dee Dee. Thank you. So that concludes the beginner and intermediate flute pieces. We're going to take a short intermission, and then we will have five of the advanced professional flute pieces. See you then. year, and it's important to recognize those who've helped in so many different ways. So first, I want to thank the East Lansing Arts Council, the East Lansing Arts Commission and the MSU Running Start Program. They both provided grants, and the MSU Running Start Program also has a competition that has been really instrumental to my growth, just as an entrepreneur and a musician and learning how to combine the two. So major thank you to those. Thank you to Emily Dembski, who helped with the organization of the applicants to make sure that all the selection committee was judging things blindly and keeping that process fair. Thank you to the judges, Elise Blatchford, Jerry Lopez, and Ramona Fantini, for their collaborative spirit and wonderful, fun conversation in the final round. We learned so much about different perspectives of professional performers, people who play music for fun, and people who are enjoying as listeners. We really have so much to learn from each other, and so I thank them for that. Thank you to Dr. Biedenbender, Dr. Elena Specht, and Christine Beamer for helping early on, just helping me focus and get all the ins and outs and logistics of this settled. And of course to Dr. Jemal Tavadze, who we'll thank again later, for his wonderful work on piano and just tackling all these new pieces. And then of course Evan Harris, who is doing the recording and live streaming today. So thank you all for the guys who did it. Now for the advanced repertoire, there are five pieces that I'll be premiering tonight. Each of these pieces had to be between 4 and 7 minutes. They could use the majority of the range of the instrument, rhythms, time signatures, extended techniques, pretty much whatever went. So my hope is that these will be great pieces for college players and professionals and those who are advanced and just enjoy playing the flute for fun. So let's get into those. Thank you. Be clever, Ariadne. You have little ears. You have my ears. Put a clever word in them. Must one not first hate oneself in order to love oneself? I am your labyrinth.
Thank you.
flute category. It's The Optimist by Henry Ives.
Thank you.
thank you all so much for coming. Thank you to those who are on the live stream. Really appreciate you all supporting this project and new flute music. I'm really hoping that this will just inspire new waves of flute repertoire for flutists of all skill levels and continue to also get listeners and adult amateurs and professionals to all come together with composers to create really exciting music for us moving forward. If you'd like, at the bottom of the program, there are two surveys. One is about your experience today. I would love to know what pieces stood out to you, what it was like hearing new music. So if you can take a few moments, that'll help me design the next call for scores. And that one's an anonymous survey. The other survey is really a form if you're interested in just kind of staying in touch with the next call for scores. If you're interested in supporting it in the future, there's no obligation, but if you're interested in being involved in any way, please fill out that form. And thank you again for coming tonight. I really appreciate it, and I look forward to hearing about your responses. Please feel free to email me or contact me through my website. So thank you all again. Have a great evening.